coronavirus, children are unable to go to school. But at this difficult time, online education is increasingly remarkably digital. Digital classes are running for young children from schools and colleges and universities. Students are being benefited greatly from this. Let us tell you how online education is growing rapidly in this era of coronavirus crisis and lockdown. What are its advantages and challenges? Online education is great for developing self-care within children. Educating experts and director of Elcon Group of Schools, Ashok Pandey, said that parents should connect children with online education so that they can come out of the negative atmosphere of coronavirus. Also, this is a good time to develop self-care within children. This is an opportunity for children to develop such qualities as self-confidence, physical fitness, and courage. Ashok Pandey himself has been conducting many online webinars to make children aware of coronavirus and is giving fitness lessons. This is how the online class is going for school children. Vinod Khare, a computer teacher at St. Thomas School in Kanpur, said, "We have just implemented Google Classroom to teach our students. First, we create a class in it and pass its code to the corresponding children of that class. The lecture is given in the digital class, then the assignments are given according to the same lecture. Zoom Cloud Meeting is also being used. However, it is facing problems like internet speed and network." According to Vinod Khare, school education has suddenly gone online due to the corona lockdown, which is causing problems for many teachers. The teacher is using 1 to 1.5 GB of data to make a 10-minute video, and there is a problem of sound in their video. But after the lockdown, if the teacher is giving the little training in digital education, then teaching online will become easier for the school teacher. Which topic is easy to teach and which is difficult in online teaching? Vinod Khare explains that it is easy to teach theory-based subjects in digital education such as English, Hindi, History, Geography, Economics. But the subject which has more to explain, there is problem with it like Maths and Science. In such subjects which are more practical based, it is easier to write on blackboard. Online education is better for which standard? According to Vinod Khare, digital education is good for pre-primary students, but it is necessary to have an interaction between students and teachers in a class above this. At the same time, digital education is very good for those preparing for graduation and the competition, because the students understand the subject well is online education and inspiration taken from Greece. According to Yashasvi Kumar, CEO of the current affair app Kien Apeli in Greece, at this time of lockdown, teaching materials are being made available on phones and national television. From this, we can also learn how education can be reached to every children in the country and to the children of the village through a digital platform. For this, educational content on TV and radio should be provided as much as possible. Content from IGNOU and UGC should be promoted. They have excellent digital education content. Online digital education will also have to reach the village. Yashasvi Kumar suggests that government teacher schools also get motivated for online education. Government teachers should also be trained in digital education. 3 hours of training is enough for the teachers, and this should be for the teachers from the university level to the school level. Children should also get training in digital education. We should prepare in such a way that the children of the village can reach education online or through TV. That's all for today. Now this is Pala Gupta signing off, and we'll be back with some more news in the next video. Till then, stay connected, stay safe. Thank you.